Hello friends, a complete training from 0 to 100 is presented to you. I hope you will find answers to your questions with this video. It is a green-colored mineral that can also be seen in blue and purple colors. Maybe the colors are not very clear in the video. Green color is copper and blue color is silver and purple color can be very little gold. Remember that in some mines, silver is also found in the form of nitrate, which is white in color and has a soft streak on the stone. Such mines have a high percentage of silver, and of course, you should not confuse it with lime. This stone that I have is not completely oxidized and has 3% sulfur, which is not very important and does not cause any problems in this test. First, pulverize the stone as much as possible so that the result of your work is better. It is a soft mineral and I easily pulverized it. Like most of you, I do not have stone crushing equipment and I crush stones manually. The good news is that the Telegram chat and review group has been launched and you can become a member of the channel from all over the world, and the channel address is in the description section. Telegram channel membership is currently free, but later it may include a membership fee. In that channel, you can easily sell or buy your jewelry and exchange experience with others, and Svandia will also help you. Well, friends, this mineral has 3% sulfur and this small amount does not cause any problems in the work. Pay attention that this is a test method and it is done with acid. So you must use the right equipment, especially eye protection. For high tonnage extraction, I will teach the cyanide and theocyanide method in a separate video. This training is for beginners and it is necessary to be very careful and understand the steps well. In this video, I try to present all the steps without editing so that you can see the details and reactions completely. I will continue working in the safety chamber because the reaction produces smoke and heat. I emphasize that you should never joke with chemicals and use safety equipment. If you don't have proper ventilation, do the tests outdoors and be sure to wear glasses. Friends, this smoke contains toxic gases. This smoke is created when there is metal or metals in the soil. The reaction of acid with metals produces orange, red, brown or yellow fumes, which are very dangerous and should not be inhaled. Of course, sometimes high acid concentration causes smoking. If you add a little water, the acid will be diluted and this smoke will be less, but I don't do this. I will tell you the details step by step so that you can understand the importance of the small tests. Look at the color of the solution. When the metals in mineral soil are dissolved in acid, the color of the solution changes to green or blue or yellow or red or black. Here, the color of the solution is blue, and this is due to the presence of copper and silver. When there is a lot of sulfur in the soil, the color of the solution changes to black. There is apparently no smoke here, but if I stir the solution, it smokes again. This is because there are still metals in the solution that are not dissolved. By adding water to the solution, make sure that there is no more metal left in the solution. When the color of the solution becomes colorless, you do not need to add water. Filtering may take some time. The filtering step is over. The color of the solution changed from greenish blue to blue because I added too much water to the solution. Here I have to reheat the solution so that the silver precipitation is done properly. If I do not heat the solution, the silver will precipitate as light halos and it will take a long time. Here the solution changed from greenish blue to pure blue because too much water was added in washing the solution. The colors may look different in the video. In order to deposit the silver well, I heat the solution. I add a small amount of dilute sulfuric acid to the solution so that the lead in the solution precipitates and does not combine with silver later. I usually use dilute sulfuric acid for work safety. Heating the solution at this stage makes the silver precipitate properly. If the solution is cold, silver will be deposited in the form of a scattered halo and it will take more time. I do not use chemical formulas and words in this video. I should have mixed the solution after adding sulfuric acid, but I will show the effect of carelessness and poor quality at the end of the video. First, I deposit silver by adding solution number 3. Be careful to use this solution as much as you need because I plan to precipitate other metals after silver and I don't want to make aqua regia. As you can see, silver is being deposited in the form of large and heavy particles. At this stage, the obtained silver nitrate should be washed several times with hot water so that copper does not remain in it, but I did not do this on purpose so that you can see the effect of carelessness on the quality of the product. First I add water and then I add some sulfuric acid. If the sulfuric acid was diluted, there is no need to use a lot of water. Of course, there are other methods to precipitate silver, but I want to extract all the elements in the soil, so I have to use this method. Now add some clean iron nails to the solution. Iron sulfate cannot be used here instead of iron. In reaction with sulfuric acid, the iron nail changes its place with silver chloride and is reduced to silver metal. In fact, first I converted the soil into silver nitrate, then using solution number 3, I converted the nitrate into chloride, and then I converted the chloride into silver metal. Instead of solution number 3, you can use concentrated salt water. It is clear that iron is changing its place with silver chloride to become silver metal. In some ways, you can turn silver into a very beautiful metal form using direct electric voltage, which I will make a video of if you like. Friends, please be careful, in some places where silver nitrate is used medicinally, that white silver powder is called silver nitrate. But in the test, its acidic solution is called nitrate, and its white precipitate in chloride solution is called. Here, the more you combine the solution, the sooner the result will be obtained. Now I add some iron nail to the remaining solution to deposit copper. Of course, aluminum can also be used, but I use iron. If there is too much sulfuric acid and number 3 solution in the solution, problems arise and the copper does not easily precipitate as a metal. I want as much copper as possible to precipitate and come out of the solution. The iron nail changes its place with copper chloride and turns into copper metal. Mix the contents of the silver container until the white particles turn into gray particles and no white particles remain. Not washing the silver chloride caused a small amount of copper to be seen here. After melting it, we will notice the poor quality of the work. I am going to show you that if you are not careful in the experiments you do, the wrong result may deceive you. It doesn't matter what metal you are extracting, even if you are extracting gold, you must be careful in all stages and do not forget any stage. Now you have to do acid washing before melting so that no acid remains in the solution. Remaining acid in the final concentrate will cause air pollution and breathing problems for you, and the quality of the molten metal will decrease and it will not have the necessary shine. Wash several times with hot water. I'm not doing this to show you the impact of carelessness. As you can see, copper is also deposited. I drain the solution so that copper metal and iron nails remain. I add zinc powder to the remaining solution to precipitate any possible remaining metals. The remaining metals in the solution are also precipitated by zinc. This deposit should also be washed with hot water, and I do not do this. Well, friends, the work is done. If you have seen the video from the beginning, you will understand what steps we went through to get here. I powdered this mineral sample, and through a chemical process, I reached three exits, and after melting each of them, I reached these metals. This is silver. Instead of being silvery and shiny, it's dull because we didn't pay attention to the details and didn't completely remove the copper from the silver chloride, remember? A small amount of copper can be seen on its surface. And this is copper. If we followed the details and acid washed, we should have reached pure and shiny copper. Do you remember I said that we will see the low quality output of the work together? When the green color remains in the solution, it means there is still copper left in it. And this one is all the remaining metals that I deposited by zinc, do you remember? As you can see, there is still a lot of copper left in it, which means that I had to wait longer for the iron nails to deposit all the copper. This process is called cementation. Aluminum metal can deposit all elements together, even gold. Of course, the condition of gold is a little different and I will check it separately. Friends, a very small amount of gold is seen here. Gold can be alloyed with copper, silver and some other metals. According to the test result, you should always perform acid washing carefully so that the metals have the required quality and purity after melting. This mineral sample contains less than 0.5% of gold, 4% of silver, 10% of copper, and 3% of sulfur. This percentage is different in mineral veins. If you have followed the experiment thoroughly, you will notice very important points that will help you later. For example, the gold in this ore is in the form of sulfide, not ions. Also comment anything you don't understand.